Hello children, hope you are all in the pink of your health. By eating nutritious food prepared by your mother at home, is it not? In this pandemic situation, you should have good health and immune power to fight against this COVID-19. Then only you can be hale and healthy. Are you all remaining home without going outside? It is safe if you safe at home. Okay. Now, today, we are going to start with a new lesson. That is lesson number 7. Weather, climate, and adaptations of animals to climate. So, this lesson is about weather, climate, and adaptations of animals to climate. Let us see, what is weather? What is weather? Short time atmospheric changes. What is weather? In atmosphere, there will be several changes. In lower classes, in the one side of the board, you will write so many columns, today's thought or one GK question. Then along with that, you will write the weather. Whether the day is sunny or rainy or cloudy like that. Do you remember that? By drawing, if it is sunny, you will draw small sun like that. Clouds or the enemies of the jobs if they drop. Remember that? Yeah, that change in the atmosphere. It is a short time atmospheric conditions. It will not prolong for long duration. For example, the previous month you would have seen the morning the day will be cloudy. From nowhere the clouds will appear, it will become dark and within a short time it may rain also. It will start to rain. Soon after it will disappear and this bright sunlight will come. Is it not? Or it will remain cloudy throughout the day. So within a day you can see the changes in the atmosphere. Such short period atmospheric changes. Short period atmospheric changes is called weather. The changes in the atmosphere. It may be cloudy or rainy. With that, you can't say that the whole day will be rainy. Or the whole day will be cloudy like that. You cannot predict that weather. Weather is a complex phenomenon. That means we cannot find the weather, what the weather will be in the next few hours like that. It will change, often changes. So weather is a short period atmospheric changes of a place and the time with respect to humidity, temperature, rainfall, okay, so the short period atmospheric changes of a place and time with respect to changes in humidity, temperature, rainfall, and another one, wind speed. Another one, wind speed. So these four factors are called as elements of the weather. Elements of weather. The weather depends on these four factors. Understand? The changes. Humidity means what? Moisture content in air. Humidity means what? Moisture content in air or atmosphere. That is called humidity. What is the temperature? The sun rays. If it is bright, it will be hot. If the sun rays are mild, the temperature will be moderate. Like that, the temperature varies. Then rainfall. If the rain is heavy, the day will be so chilly. If there is drizzling, the temperature will be mild and cool. And if there is no rain, it will be hot like that. Next, wind speed. According to the blow velocity of wind blowing. If the wind is mild, we will call it as breeze and we feel it very comfortable. But heavy wind blows somewhat with force. It will be somewhat difficult for us, is it not? So, according to the elements of the weather, these are all elements of the weather. According to these factors only, the weather will be determined. You understand? Weather is nothing but the short period atmospheric changes, and it is a complex phenomenon. We cannot predict the weather. That means we can't say confirmly whether the day will be cloudy or sunny like that. When you get up and go outside in the morning at 6 o'clock, it may be cloudy and it will be very pleasant. But after that, the bright sunshine may be there. You can't bear the heat of the sun. Suddenly, from nowhere, the clouds may appear in the rainy season and it may start to rain. So, like this, the weather changes in a day itself. So, such a complex phenomenon. And the weather is determined by the factors such as humidity, temperature, rainfall, and wind speed. These are called elements of weather. Understand? And this humidity is nothing but moisture content.
The maximum and minimum temperatures are measured with the help of special type of thermometer commonly called as the maximum and minimum thermometers. The maximum temperature of the day is usually recorded in the afternoon. The minimum temperature of the day is usually recorded in the early morning. Thus, afternoons are the hottest and the early mornings are the coldest time of the day. The maximum or highest temperature reached during the day and the minimum temperature reached during the early morning are recorded at meteorological stations every day. This information is important for weather monitoring.
That will be measured by an instrument called rain gauge. This is a measurement called rain gauge. It is nothing but a jaw-like or beaker-like with the measurements in there, and at the top of a funnel will be there for collection of this rainwater. And it will be fixed to a stand. And this rain gauge will be fixed to a stand and will be kept in an open place. And the rainwater directly will fall into this funnel and it will be collected in the beaker, and in the measurement we can measure how much millimeter rain. In the news and all, in the weather forecast, you can hear that this certain amount of rainfall was there in a particular place. So they were calculated using this. Rainfall is calculated using the rain gauge. This is a simple instrument. Understand? And wind speed. For that also, one barometer, the atmospheric pressure will be measured by barometer, and another instrument is there. Understand? So these are the factors. Now, this way, does. So these data are collected by a department. The department is there called Meteorological Department. There is a special department for this called Meteorological. Meteorological Department. MeteorologicalMeteorological Department. This you have to pronounce it correctly. That department only collects the data from various places and predict the weather. And they say the weather was like this. Last week the weather was like this. Tomorrow the weather will be like this. It may be cloudy or it may be rainy or heavy sunset will be. And the people who predict this weather are called meteorologists. And this study of weather is called meteorology. Logy means to study. Logy means what? To study. So study about weather is called meteorology. Meteorology. And the department which study that weather, collecting the data, these factors, depending on these factors, are called meteorological department. And this data are collected by a special a person. Specialist will be there, and those persons are called as meteorologists. So with the help of this only, they are collecting the data and predicting the weather. Next, in what ways this meteorological department helping us in predicting the weather? What is the advantage of predicting the weather? So this data collected and giving information to the public or the people is called weather forecast. Portion, that is at the end of the news, they will say the weather forecast. So in this only, they will say about the atmospheric conditions. And this weather forecast, what are the advantages? Advantages of a weather forecast. This helps the people to face about the bad weather. They will know if the weather will be very bad, means they will be useful to maintain their daily activities. For example, if any function is going to be held in your family, means the elders will discuss about that weather and all, whether it will be rainy during the day. So we can have the function at the top of the our house, in the roof of the house, or in separate hall, separate function hall like that. They'll be discussing where we can have that function. So it helps to design our daily activities, to plan our daily activities, this weather forecast. And also helps the people to face the bad weather, forthcoming bad weather. They will be precautious. They will be precautiously they will move to some other places if they are living in a low area before the flood. The weather forecast will be given to the people that the heavy rain, the water may enter these areas, and also the people better to leave to some other areas, the high level areas like that. Is it not? So in this way, the weather forecast helps the people to face the forthcoming bad weather or to plan their daily activities. So this is the what about the weather? There is short period atmospheric changes of a place and time with respect to various factors such as humidity, rainfall, temperature, and wind speed and all. Are you clear about the weather? Okay. Next one is we are going to see about climate. The next topic is climate. Now we saw about weather. The next one is climate. What is climate? The average weather condition of a place, of any place, over a period of time is called climate. Average weather condition of a place over a period of time. So, weather is nothing but the atmospheric changes of a place and time. That means for a short duration, is it not? Within the period, limited period, what will happen? But what about the climate? Climate is an average weather condition of a place over a period of time. That means for a long term. It is a long term. Weather is a short period, it is a short duration. But climate is an average, long term average weather condition. And this is calculated using two steps. With the two steps, we can calculate the climate of a place. That means, what are those two steps? Now, how the climate, the average temperature, how it will be calculated? For example, we will say, what about Jammu and Kashmir? It will be so cool there, is it not? Covered with ice and all, and the weather will be so cool because almost throughout the year it will be covered with snow. The northern part of the region and all. As it is below the Himalayas. So the climate will be cool, we are saying. What about our Tamil Nadu and all? Even in Tamil Nadu, hilly stations are so cool always. That is why we are moving to that place. And here where we are living as a moderate or hot. So some humid and hot like that we will say, the climate of a place. How means they will calculate the average temperatures for a month. For example, in a month 30 days are there. So they will calculate the 30 days temperature and they will take the average of a month. For example, in the exam, if someone will ask, they won't ask a mark of each and every subject, just they will say what percentage are you scoring. If you have 5 subjects, what will you do? You will add those 5 subject marks and you will divide by 500 and it will convert it for 100. Is it not? That total you are getting over 500. For example, 450. And you will convert that into 100. That is the percentage of your mark. Is it not? So what it will be? 450 means 90%. Is it not? So 90% is your mark. That means in all subject average is 90. Near around 90 you have got, that is the meaning. In the same way, the climate is also calculated in two steps, that is average temperature during the month. First they will calculate for a month. First step, average temperature during a month. That means, how many days are there? 30 days are there. Is it not? So, the 30 days temperatures daily they will calculate and they will add those 30 calculations and they will divide by the total number of days. That is the average temperature during a month. That means, sum of daily temperatures by number of days in a month. That means in a month how many days are there? 30 days. So daily, for example, 20 degrees Celsius plus so hot, it may reach up to 35 and 33. Average will be like this. That is 30 calculations will be there. Those 30 days temperature rating add, this is sum of daily temperatures. And then divide by number of days in a month. How many days in a month? Average 30. So like this, they will add the daily temperature and they will divide by number of days in a month. That is the average temperature during a month. For 1 month, this is the average temperature. Like this, in second step, long-term average temperature. Long-term average temperature they will calculate. Long-term average temperature of a place or a particular month, and they will calculate. This is the climate. Long-term average temperature is called climate. Is it not? They will calculate this by sum of monthly averages. Sum of monthly averages. By number of months. We understand. So sum of monthly averages means what? In a year, how many months will be there? 12 months average, mean average. Now, this is for 1 month. Average temperature during a month. Is it not? Here they will take one value. Like this one, 12 months they will calculate. And those 12 values they will add. And they will divide by number of months. So how many months? 12. So like this only, they will calculate the climate. Climate is nothing but the long-term average weather. So for the month, they will calculate like the sum of daily temperatures by number of days in a month. For a month, they will calculate like this. The next long-term average temperature means for 12 months. Sum of monthly averages by number of months. Like this, they will calculate the climate. Okay, so by calculating these things and all, they are saying that the place is a hot climate, having hot climate or humid climate or cold climate, like that they are fixing that the place as whether it is hot, cold or humid. Understand? Generally they are not saying. That means for decades means what? 10 years. They will calculate this long-term average for more than decades, up to 25 years like that. They will calculate and they are coming to a decision that one particular place is hot or humid or cold like that. Now do you understand how they are fixing a place whether it's hot or cold? Okay. Next. If you understand this, it will be really easy. It's a simple problem. Next. Next one, adaptations of animals to climate. Now, various animals and plants living in this earth, they can't live wherever they are found. They need a particular temperature, particular level of water. This is not like that. They need a particular climate to adapt to live. For example, as we are human beings, what we will do if there is a heavy rain? In that heavy rain also, if we want to move outside the house, we will wear raincoat to protect ourselves. Then, like that, if it is so hot, what will you do? You may use an umbrella to protect from the sunlight. Is it not? Then for chillness or cold, in the winter season, and what will you do? You will wear sweaters to protect yourself from the severe cold. So you are following certain things to protect yourself. In the same way, animals also, they will protect themselves by having some adaptation. So, what is that adaptation? What is that adaptation? That means adaptation is nothing but that means changing their conditions, developing conditions to protect them from their changes, climatic changes, by developing some particular habits or changes in their physical appearance itself. That is called adaptation. Sensational changes will be there. Okay, that is called adaptations. According to the place where they live, they will have some special features. That is called adaptations. Now, what for example, we will take two regions. One is polar region and another one is tropical rainforest. So these two regions we will take today for discussing about adaptations. Another one is tropical rainforest. We will take these two regions. Hope you all know what is polar region. That means they were always covered with snow. They are present in North Pole and South Pole. As it is away from the equator, the social studies have studied about these and not. This is not. The central part is the equator, and these two are the polar north and south poles, and in between the Tropic of Cancer, the Tropic of Capricorn is there. And this is the Tropic of Cancer or tropical region, these two. And this is the equator, and this is the north pole, and this is the south pole. And these two poles, as they are away from the equator, always covered with what is that? Snow. That is why it's called as polar region. And the well-known example in polar regions, what are they? Polar bear and penguins. Polar bears and penguins. These two animals that are seen generally in all the places in polar regions, is it not? And most of these polar regions are located, means what are all the countries located in these polar regions? Iceland, then Norway, then in US some parts, Alaska, like that, main range, Meridian, like that. So many places are located in these polar regions. And animals, how they get adapted, what changes they have in their physical appearance to face that cold climate. That is what we are going to see, that is called adaptation. And this polar region, these penguins, polar bears and penguins, they will have white fur. First we will see about the polar bear. They will have a double layer, two thick layers of fur, white fur, which matches with two thick layers of white fur. Two thick layers of white fur. You would have noticed about that polar bear, fully white in color, which matches with their background. Is it not? Snow area is of fully white in color, so that when these are also in that region, as they are having white fur in nature, this helps them to escape from their predators. Even if their enemies want to attack them, they cannot identify these polar bears easily, as they are matched with their surroundings. They can't identify them easily. Even this adaptation helps them to catch their prey. They also can easily go and catch their prey. And this two thick layer of white fur coated on their skin helps them to protect from the severe cold. And beneath this two thick layer, a layer of fat is present. Fat is present in the under of the skin. Fat under the skin, they help them to protect by acting as insulator. Insulator means what? Not conducting the heat. That means if you are wearing the sweater, how do you feel? Even it is cold outside, you will form inside the sweater. You will feel warm inside the sweater. Because the sweater acts as insulator, that means it will not allow the heat to escape outside the sweater. and also will not allow the cold air to enter into the sweater. That is why the temperature is maintained inside the sweater itself, so that you feel warm when you wear the sweater. So that sweater acts as an insulator. In the same way, the fat under the skin, thick layer of fat will be present, and that fat acts as insulator. It keeps the animals warm. They prevent them from the cold, severe cold. Understand? So, next one, they have broad and large feet, large paws. Paws means what? The foot. They have broad and large. That helps them to walk on the snow. And also, they will swim in the water in summer. And also to catch their prey. They eat fish and all, is it not? As it is covered with snow everywhere, the ice will be, the water will be very cold. And these bats, what they will do means, they will get inside the water and they will catch the fish to eat. And these large and broad paws help them to swim. And while swimming, they will be able to hold their breath for a long duration. They will close their nostrils without breathing. They are having the capacity to hold their breath for long duration. This helps them to swim under the water. Next, so these things help the polar bears to survive in the polar region. Two layers of thick fur matches with the surroundings, and they have a thick layer of fat under the skin which help them to prevent them from the severe cold, and they have broad and large paws. Another one thing, important thing is hibernation. Hibernation means what? That is long sleep in winter. Long sleep in winter. To escape during winter and all, the animals cannot bear the cold. The snowfall will be there. They can't go outside and all. So what they will do means, for 6 months they will have a long sleep. They will not have to get up in between. That long sleep in winter is called hibernation. They carry this to escape from the severe cold. Understand? So they have a long sleep. During the time they won't take food also. This fat under the skin, they act as reserve food for them. These fat, they will provide the energy for them. So these are the characters or the adaptations of what the polar bears have to allow them to live in the polar regions. Next, another one, penguins. Already all of you have might have known. Penguins move their breath, and the same way they also have a white fur at the belly region, the front portion. And also they have a small fur, and they also have a layer of fat under the skin which will help them to protect them from the severe cold. In the same way they have webbed feet. They also have webbed feet, which helps them to swim in water. They also will swim in water to catch the fish that is a food for them. So using the webbed feet, they will be able to swim in water. And they will also, what they will do means, during severe cold and all, they will huddle each other. Huddle each other. Huddle means what? They will join together. In pairs they will join together, remain close to each other, so that they can maintain the warmth between them. To escape from the severe cold, always they will huddle with each other. For example, at home, only few members will be there. Lot of space will be there, good aeration will be there, so you will feel comfortable. But when you move to a party or some functions and all, crowd will be there. How you will feel there? Somewhat hot, and you will feel sultry. You will feel some uncomfortable. is it not? In the same way, these penguins, in pairs, they will huddle each other to escape from the cold. When they are joined together, they will feel the warmth. They will maintain the warmth between them. Okay, and they are also able to swim under water with the help of their webbed feet and the front pair of limbs. Flippers, it is called as flippers. That flippers help them to swim in water. These adaptations help them to swim under water to catch the prey. So these are the two regions, the polar regions, these are the two organisms, how they are able to live in the climate, cold climate, extreme cold climate. Understand? Next we shall come to tropical rainforest. The next adaptation is tropical rainforest. Another one, in the polar regions, the temperature will be minus 37 degrees Celsius in winter and all. What will be? Even in the zero or below zero, we are not able to live. Is it not? But what about the temperature in the polar regions? Minus 37 degrees Celsius. In the minus 37 degrees Celsius, that means in winter. So think of how cold it will be. But what about the tropical rainforest here in this region? The temperature will be always between 15 degrees Celsius to 35 or 45 degrees Celsius. 15 to 45 degrees Celsius will be the temperature. And this will rainforest, tropical rainforest will be found in the Western Ghats in India. This found in the Western Ghats and in Assam and all, these type of tropical rainforests are seen. And as temperature, and there in this tropical rainforest, the trees will be very dense. Dense means what? It will grow in close, heavy, thick, dense growth of trees will be there. And the temperature is also moderate from 15, even in winter, heavy winter, the temperature will be from 50 degrees Celsius. It will not be so cold. And in summer, it may extend up to 45 degrees Celsius. So, as the temperature is also suitable for living, numerous number of varieties of living organisms are seen, even from small insects to large animals. All types of the population of the animals or birds or even insects will be seen in this tropical rainforest because it suits for better adaptations. Even the temperature is moderate, most of the animals will be arboreal. Arboreal means what? They may be living on trees. They will be living on trees. Mostly they live on trees. Because as the temperature allows the animals to live there, they are not no need for them to come down to the ground. The top of the trees will be so dense and thick and they can live up there itself by having enough food. No need for these animals to come down on the earth and search for food. On the top of the trees itself, they can get enough food for them. So most of the time, they will be living on the trees itself. That is arboreal. For this example, macaque is a lion-tailed monkey. They can hold you almost fruits, then leaves, buds, flowers, and some insects on the bark. This itself is enough for their food. They will feed on these things, and no need for that monkey to come down on the earth to find for their food. Understand? So, arboreal animals means living on trees. In that first example is macaque. What is the pronunciation? Macaque. Macaque means lion-tailed monkey, which is having a white mane like lion around its face with a white beard. And in past are adapted in such a way they could live on the branches, hold the branches easily. With the tail also help them to swing on the branches by holding the branches. So they feed on the buds, flowers, then twigs, fruits, and some insects found on the barks of the trees. As they can feed like this, no need for them to come and open the ground. Mostly it will spend their time on the trees itself. Next one is red-eyed frog. This red-eyed frog, they have the limbs with the nuptial pads. That means sticky pads. In the fingers, end of the fingers, they will have the nuptial. That means they can attach with the leaves itself. It won't fall down. It will have the grip. So, with the help of that the nuptial pads, the four limbs and all, the red-eyed frogs also mostly will be seen on the leaves of the trees itself. They will also not come down. Understand? Next. These two are the arboreal example for the arboreal. Next one is, you can see that buffaloes. What these buffaloes will do means, I think all of you know about the buffaloes, their skin color is black. And as it is black in color, the black color always will absorb more heat, the sun's heat. So in summer, they can't bear the heat, it's too hot. So what these buffaloes will do means they will go and take rest in the water, inside the water or the puddle seen in the forest. That is why to maintain their temperature, to escape from the heat, these buffaloes, what they will do means they will go and take rest in water. Another one example is we can see that the elephants. We all know what this elephant, how it will look like. It will have very large ears, is it not? It will help them to hear the sharp sounds. The ears will be very sharp to hear even small sounds. They can observe small sounds. And also, by waving his ears, they can maintain the temperature of their body. The waving of the ears helps them to keep their body cool or to maintain the temperatures. And their nostrils, that means they will have a long trunk, and the incisors are converted, the tusk what you are seeing on both sides of their trunk, that is nothing but the modified incisors. The tusk, the white color, thunder, so that is nothing but the modified incisors. Modified incisors, that is nothing but modified incisors. So, these are the animals. Next one, even in the polar regions, to escape from that severe cold, they will go for long sleep, I said, is it not? In the same way, to escape from the heat also, in summer, what they will do means they often take rest because of the heat produced in their body to avoid overheating. That means heat produced in their body, they will often take rest to maintain their temperature. If animals, this is the case in animals, means what birds will do? What birds will do? One typical example in a tropical rainforest is toucan. T-O-U-C-A-N, but the pronunciation of this is toucan. As a two vowels are are coming together, the sound of the first vowel only we have to pronounce. That is toucan. This toucan bird, it will have a very large beak. When comparing to their body, the beak will be very large and broad. So, these bird also somewhat heavy, but in these tropical rainforests, as numerous living organisms are seen, there will be competition for food also. So, these toucan, it will not be able to get, it will feed on the fruits and seeds. How they are able to get seeds means with the help of its large and broad beak. Even if the fruits are seen in the small twigs of the trees, they can't go and sit on that particular twig or branch and can have it. Because of their weight, their branch will not support. So, sitting on a heavy branch itself, with the help of its broad and large beak, they can catch their food, that fruits, even which is present in the small twigs. They can easily get their food. And these birds, to escape from the severe heat in summer and all, they will, to summer or winter, they migrate. The birds will migrate. Migration means what? Movement of living organisms for a particular short period from one place to another to escape from the severe cold or heat. Is it not? That is called migration. These migration will take place amongst the birds. That means in groups they will move from one place to another. For example, Siberian crane. In tropical rainforest, the example is Siberian crane. These birds will move from Siberia to even to India, Bharatpur bird sanctuary. It is present in Rajasthan. Then in Haryana, Sultanpur National, bird sanctuary is there. So from Siberia it will travel to, even in Tamil Nadu, Medanangal bird sanctuary is there. There are also many birds from different parts of the world. They will come there for migration. They will stay there, they will breed there once, and then again they will move to their same place. Along with that, when they move also, they will move in group. That means that it is the shape only they will move, like a triangular shape. Like that it will move. So the birds, what they do means that they adapt migration. That means moving from one place to another to escape from the severe cold or heat. So these are some of the adaptations seen among the animals. And in India, this tropical rainforest is formed in Assam and in Western Ghats and all. Next, these adaptations help the animals to live in these two regions. Next. Another one example is a chameleon. That animal you know. It has a large eyes bulged out and a long tongue, sticky tongue, which helps them to roll out while catching their prey. The prey will stick to their tongue and again it will roll it back inside the mouth. And the eyes also, the right eye can see the front side and the left eye can see the back side at the time. So its eyes can rotate in all 360 degrees Celsius. Like this, different animals adapt to different characteristics to live in this environment. Understand? So in this class, we saw about the weather, climate and adaptations of animals to climate. Weather is short changes in the atmosphere during a particular, in short duration, day-to-day changes in the climate, in the atmosphere. Next, climate is the long-term changes over years. That is called the climate, and how we can measure, what department, meteorological department is there, they calculate this climate and all. The weather forecast help us to plan our daily activities like that. And adaptations, how the animals are adapted to different climate. And for that we took two as example. One is polar region and another one is tropical rainforest. In that, how the animals are able to adapt themselves. Everything we discussed in this, with this lesson is over. So along with this, I will send the classwork as PDF and worksheet also. You all Thank you, children.